Ranos here, and welcome to episode of Shipbreaker. So, how about we figure out what ship we're cutting next? Because this bugger kind of, we had an issue with it. There's nothing to continue with, silly thing. Not finding anything else. How about we go for a smaller ship? Something that won't take too long. Let's see if we've got any. Oh, we've got an unknown right here. So I've got 5, so this one's going to be a small. So yeah, let's do this one. Hey, should be interesting. The scout patrol craft. Alright, so this is going to be more of a personnel transport by the looks of it. So we won't have to worry too much about cargo and stuff, but pressurization's still going to be a bit of an issue.
Robert reports looking good, folks. I think things are really turning around here. Joseph, when I leave, eventually, what are you going to change to keep profits up like this? When are you leaving? When this team gets its respect for the company back. Which, at this rate, seems like never. What do you say, Joseph? Well, truth be told, I don't think I can ever do what you do. How? Well, that's your problem right there. Maybe.
Oh, whoops. Forgot about the whole AI thing. For a second there. Not close enough to get that. Can I get close enough? No. Alright, let's get you out of there and then I can deal with the AI. Nope, get back here, you bugger. Yeah, stop right there. Hold you right there. And destroy. Alright, that should be a better angle. Hey! Another AI node right here. Damn little bugger. Yeah. There we go. Anyway, let's put you back in there. Let's see if we can find any more AI nodes. There's something there. I think there's... what is that? It's having a bit of a problem showing me, but it is. Yeah, thruster fuel. Yeah, I think this is the best one to see the AI nodes with. Yeah. Anyway. Get rid of this bugger. There we go. Now let's get this bugger off and send it down. This one's going to need to be cut off. There we go. Let's do the other side. Yeah, no AI node on this thing. Get it down to the barge. Here we are. Yeah, and a bunk. Here we go. Now then. Oh yeah, this has double engine on the back, doesn't it? Why don't I try getting other things off first? Got this weird attachment on the side. That could just be pulled right off. There's no AI node attached to it, but there's quite a few inside. Sensor tower. Huh. Well, there's the entrance. Alright. At least I know that these areas at the back are not pressurized. These sorts of things don't get pressurized. What's that? I got a storage bin there. Oh, we got a blue wall. That's where I gotta move. Thruster fuel. Thruster fuel. Wow. Quite a bit of thruster fuel. So I guess I won't have to buy any for a while. Let's pull this off. Bring it over here. And get it into the processor. And here we go. And now we head on over. I get the next one from this side. Pull this in a bit. Swing it over that way. And throw it. I'm not doing too bad already. And off it goes. Swing it over this way. And it goes. Now this one. And then we'll work on removing the thrusters. There we go. Now let's see. is this one I have to deal with the inside immediately? I don't remember. Oh yeah, once I detach the thruster, or once I try to remove this, I'll have a time limit. I have to try and get it out, and then get all the way over here to activate a switch immediately. Ay, ay, ay. Anyway, let's just get these nozzles off first. There we go, that's one done. Right down to the barge once I've got the other one up. Oh, hello! I'll take those off after I've detached them from the main thing. And when I say detached, I mean once the shells come off. Well, can I get taken off now? They don't seem to do anything. Daddy's barking. Yeah, they don't seem to do anything here. Who knows, maybe leaving them on might be a good idea. I need to just take them off once I've dealt with the insides. Daddy's barking. And bunk. Each one seems to come with two. Yeah, let's go down. Bring this over that way. Yeah, and a bunk. Yeah, I'm gonna have to check out what she's barking at. Back in a second. Someone else's bloody cat was in. Not sure where the kitty cat came from. But the bugger going to the bathroom. So, let's do this quick. And let's do this one. Let's pull this bugger out. Let's go in. And move it down to the line. Oy, fuel pipes are getting destroyed. There we go. Dealt with. Hey. Now you get to the barge. There we go. Now let's take these off. Mine. Not sure I need so many. In mine. Alright, I think that's all of the ones for that. There's a few other bits and pieces to remove. Like this. Oops. Didn't mean to push the whole thing. Here we go. Now then, anything else in these things that I need to get rid of? I'm not seeing any AI on these things. The frick at all is that? Heatsink. Alright. Don't need more of them, but I'll take it. Wow, these things are actually light enough for me to pull now. Well, more that my tool's strong enough to pull them. Not by a lot, though. Yeah, pull this one this way. Not like that. So I can easily angle them, but pulling them not so much. Oh my. Oh, there's a big thing on the bottom, isn't there? Okay. That's that moving. Basically everything else on the off and thrown into there. Like I just tell it to that and put it up here. Pull you off. And throw you down. Just make sure the furnace doesn't try stealing it. Put on multiple. Hey, yeah, everything's off. Good. Alright, it's getting to the right spot. Yeah, break tethers. And it goes. I think it got stuck. Yep, it got stuck. Give me a sec to realign it. I don't think that's realigning. I have to touch to another solid object just to. Huh. End up putting scrap in there, but no, you can do about that. Hey, at least I didn't actually lose anything. Let me cut that up in a moment. I think I'll take this off. And throw that down. Now, let's get this side. Yep. And there we go. Go over there for now. Bit far and out of the way, but oh well. Gonna try and make this one go in properly. Make sure the furnace doesn't try and steal it. And also make it move a bit quicker. Okay. And do that. And over here. They're going in that direction. Do this to stop its rotation. Now that should just go right in without any issues. Yeah. Should do. Yeah. May as well just head on and deal with the rest of the thruster. By first, taking this off. That more scrap just went in there. Oh well. No, you do about that when it gets burnt up. And this. Here we go. Now this can go to the barge. There. Is that done? O2's starting to drop a little bit. We can get the next one off before I need to go for more oxygen. Although we can also get the rest of the front off. Well, the bottom, should I say. Let's head over here. Look at this. Now this goes to the barge. This little thing. Oh, processor. Getting close to reaching the first goal. Alright. Now how about we deal with the other thruster? Before we start taking a pokey on the inside. Hey. How complicated is this one's interior? Let's see. This one will be a lot easier, so I might be able to get down there before anything burns up. Who knows? Might be able to avoid things being scrapped. But as long as I'm still able to attain 52%, I don't think it's going to be that big of a deal. And... Now this one. Pull you out. And in I go. Ah, buggering hell. What's up, bird? Okay. That's that done. Didn't lose anything this time. It's good. Alright, let's get you down. And over we go. Yay, first goal reached. Alright. Oh yeah, need to get those things. Coolant. Make sure I don't break them. Or they'll break everything else. Alright. Let's get you. And now, because it's got these big wing things in the way, we have to use tethers to try and make him go up instead. Hopefully that works. Might be too much of an angle though. Yeah, too much of an angle for that one. That speed is still going up though. That might be the better way to do it. Get it up. And now, I put over there. Hopefully that works. This one's a bit more awkward, unfortunately. Let's see if I can do this one without using tethers. I do have a lot of them, so it's not going to be that big of an issue. Come on, you big bugger. Get a move on. My oxygen's running low. I'm going to restore it by spending time inside the ship, taking a look at things and destroying whatever AI nodes I come across. The tether already broke. It should be fine going that way on its own now. This one's got far away enough from the thing. It should be fine to do this. And over there. Yeah, let's do that one too. Go. Hopefully that'll bring it. Kind of bumped in the ship there, but it's not moved it. It should be fine. Let's pull this one. And over here. Is it nice being able to just to remove things without worrying about it going boom? That should be fine. And do this one. If I push this down now, it might hit that and cause an explosion. Not what we want. Let's get this one moving a bit quicker. Alright. And let's get this one. Different angle. Yeah, I know my oxygen's low. You're fine. Don't worry about it. I'm going to go inside the ship soon anyway. Down it goes. Should go inside. Here we are. Now then, let's get in here. The warning's definitely changed. I'm in a pressurized area. Oh, this is different. Navigation table. Did they add a ton of new things? Huh, oh wow. Two AI units. Alright, give me a second, just collecting things. And let's get rid of you. Let's get rid of you. Now, that one's damaged. Well, that randomly happened. Now we get rid of you. There we go. There's a note there. That's the exterior. Don't open that while we still got things in here. Wow, the note's all the way all over the place. It's over there. What the? Hey, let me in. Ooh, helmet.
Okay. Right. Recording this, and then I gotta dash it. Someone has boarded us. Don't know who yet. They hit us with I don't know. It must have been an EMP or something. Every ship system went down. Then they booted it all back up when something just scrapped us. I could hear the clamps. I heard them cutting in through the hull. Now, if they are bandits, they are a hell of a lot more sophisticated than anything we have run into before. They took over all our systems. Doors are locked and overrides are disabled. The comms are offline. They turned off the 10 lights and we are trapped in the dark. I can hear them in the water. Oh no. They are in the next room. Please, whoever gets this, tell Harold Lamar on IO Way Station 9. Ted loves him.
Uh-huh. Interesting. Great! Try to destroy AI nodes, but I end up burning it on thing. Nope, gotta keep it away from that side to stop any more fires. How do I put out this fire? Maybe depressurizing? Okay, we'll go out. Hey. Hey, you. I want to destroy you. Please don't highlight things I want to break. Hey, hey, hey. Well, I'm destroying nodes. Destroy a few too many other things. Oh, does this mean the outer area is depressurized? Oh, the shell on the outside's not pressurized. Well, that's handy. That is an extremely dangerous location. Alright, let's see. Really? You pressurized it? How'd you manage that, you bugger? Oh, node up there. Okay. This AI node on the reactor. Two up there, one here, another one over there by the looks of it. One on the side here. Let's get rid of that one now without any worries. Can I get back in there? No. How the frick did they pressurize this area? Where's the atmosphere control unit down here? Systems. Oh, there's one there. That looks like it's right above the airlock. How the frick did they pressurize this area? There's one there, one there. That one works. That one's broken. Well, that's in a different area, isn't it? They've depressurized the entire ship apart from the compartments I'm in. You little buggers! I don't want to destroy any more of them because, you know, I need them to cycle it. So I don't know how they actually pressurize this place. How the frick do you guys manage that? Well, now I'm stuck in here. Damn little buggers. Don't want to do an explosive decompression. So they're the only ones that can actually pressurize and depressurize regions while the doors are open. That's a bit odd. Not there like that. Can you guys, you know, depressurize this place for me? Or pressurize somewhere else? Oh, you guys want to be a pain in the butt. Nope, they're doing something. Yay, I can go through here now. Hey, yoy. You damn little buggers. I need to have this one equipped. Yeah, that one's all busted, so that's not gonna work. Wait, then how did they depressurize this area? Oh yeah, this one. Up there's still depressurized. That area is still pressurized. Maybe if I click on depressurize, this area will depressurize. Well, no, that didn't work. Well, that plan didn't go as well. That didn't go according to plan. Well then, what to do? I guess while the entire thing's still depressurized, Won't taking the backup there, like, depressurize the compartments as well? Causing potentially catastrophic issues? Yeah, that place is now pressurized. Well, taking off the faceplate... No, taking off the faceplate won't cause the whole thing to explode. Yeah, if I take off that front plate before they're able to pressurize it, I'll be able to start removing things. Yeah, that should work. Hoping. I'm hoping it doesn't cause everything to blow up. I want that happening again. And... please don't cause the entire vessel to blow up. Hey, let's put you in the furnace. Now I know this place can't be refilled. Here we are. Now just wait until they depressurize the compartments. Then I'll immediately make a cut that prevents them from repressurizing it. I don't really want to deal with the rest of the AIs until I've got the whole thing open. Oh! There we go. I just went in through the door that was open. Pressurized. Cargo's still pressurized. Now I depressurize cargo. Alright, need to make a cut to get one of these panels off before it begins to pressurize again. But where? What cuts do I make? Oh, that one should do. And that one. Has not come off yet. Alright, now they can't pressurize this area. That is not the entire ship. How the frick did I manage that? Ah, balls. Oh no. How did I nudge the entire ship? Well, that stuff's moving. That's good. I would figure out how to get the rest of the... may as well just cut everything I can see. Maybe that'll help get the whole thing off. Do that. Do this. And this one. And this one. And now let's get this one. Maybe if it's done all this, it'll actually let me start taking it off. And... to the top. Alright. Here we go. And now here. And now that one. And that should be everything cut, right? Yeah. So I should be able to move this out of the way. Oh yeah, it's moving. It's not going to pull the whole ship with it, luckily. over there. Now let me make sure there's nothing outside, yeah? Although it would be considered a bit late now because it's already flying off. Hey! Bloody thing. Here we go. Let's get you over there. Okay, you're good. Hey. Let's continue emptying this thing. Let's get this over here. Now, why don't I take this off first as well? Come on, faceplate. Time for you to be removed. We go. And launch. Hey. All right. Now that I'm gonna leave there for now. Take it out later. You know, when I need the fuel. And you. And now you. Should be able to reach that second tier in a moment. And now this one. And bunk. And down he goes. That's another goal reached. This one. I'm gonna make sure I leave all door panels intact because the AI is gonna keep messing with the darn things. And bring this over here. Now let's grab this one. Now let's grab this one. Here we go. Alright. Most of this is for the furnace. The interior shell typically is. Here we go. Here we go. Another piece. Alright. That's this place almost done. These things don't really matter. I'm normally just destroying this anyway, so I may as well just let the whole thing get dumped into the furnace. Oy, let's get the rest of this shell off, shall we? Here we go. Anything on you? No. Off it goes. He spins. Okay, while this place is depressurized and open, I'm taking you. You cheeky little! At least one door's still open. There's that. Neat. Now he has one atmosphere control unit to play with. And also the airlock. Trying to keep in place. Oopsie. Try to make me power it up, despite it not being plugged in. Alright, let's see. Now let's get this, get the trash into the furnace. Yeah, this one. And a bunk. Alright. Let's see what else we can do. I want to get the back panel off first before I properly empty this room. Look, hello. Bit rude of ya. All right, let's get the AI unit off the reactor, and then we'll pull the reactor. That might be a good idea to get this one out of the way first. Let's do that. Wait for it. There we go. Is there anything on you that you shouldn't be having? Nope. That's good. Off it goes. Alright, now the reactor time. Now that everything around it's clear. Here we go. Why is the housing for it for the processor? The housing for the reactor is usually for the processor or the furnace. We had a habit recently making sure that the thing matched what it was attached to. And at this time, I guess. Let's just pull the darn thing. And boom. Reactor done. Anyway, let's see. Anything on this thing? No. Let's pull you and put you to the barge. Let's head up and over. Anything on this one? No. Good. They start only latching onto the more dangerous items. So there's a bit of a spin. I'm gonna take it off first, get as far away just in case I make a mistake. That should be far enough. Wait for it to stabilize. And that should be good enough.